I put them all back like some kind of dork.
Hello.
Shouldn't you be like shooting my feet?
Yeah. I'm getting the shoes.
I understand. Okay, I want to show you how to use my color wheel. And what I've done to make this easier for you to see is I've actually added the paint chips that belong to the system colors all around the color wheel. So you can do this too with yours, but this is what I've done to make it easier to see. So the best way to use this wheel, because this gives you like an overall 9 undertones with the whites on the back. And here's the thing, it's not gonna give you every neutral in the world, but it's gonna help you define most neutrals, because that's the reason why my system works so well, because most of the time when you plunk this down and get the lighter and darker versions of the neutral, you will be able to see what the undertone is by plunking it down on tile, on fabrics, where on stone, wherever it is that you need to, where you're not sure, you're like, what is this? Is it blue gray? Is it green gray? What is it? So
this is a great example. My blue gray Carrera countertop. We're gonna plunk down the color wheel, and you can see when you go around, which is the one that matches. Oh, the blue gray samples look so good with my blue gray countertop. So then what you do, and don't forget, you always need that white backdrop, is you plunk down your Coventry gray, which is kind of a mid-tone blue gray, and you can see how great that looks. Then Stonington gray, a shade lighter, and then Horizon, which is even lighter. Now, what the color wheel is not going to do, it's not going to spit out all the possible colors that exist in the universe that are gonna go with blue gray Carrera. It's not that smart.
The wheel works best for simply identifying the undertone of whatever it is you're looking at, and then that's gonna give you the starting point for the palette. So depending on, you might be in a bedroom and you have a pink beige duvet, and so you plunk this down and go, oh, my duvet is pink beige. And then you might pull out all your pink beiges from the system and then choose the one that works in the room. So in that case, you would choose that, the pale pink beige, and you'd paint the room pink beige, all as well.
Actually, is that let's say that you pull out Coventry gray and you can see how great it looks with the blue gray, but your client's like, well, I don't want it. It's too dark. Well, this is that now you work backwards to the lighter shade, and that is how you then work with the darker samples that you may or may not be specifying right now, because the trend is that everybody wants something super pale. So that's how you work with the color wheel. And you need it.